Afternoon, Jonathan, and well, we've got rid of almost all of the Christmas crackers, I guess, by now, but he's absolutely right. It is a cracker of a race here. I really would struggle to introduce everybody here. We've only got 4 kilometres to do it, but one or two before we get going. The man who won a bronze at the European Championships, and great support from the Scottish crowd for Chris O'Hare. And Chris knows he's got a real task on his hands here, because this field is full of World Olympic champions on the track and on the cross country, including the Commonwealth champion from Glasgow, James Magut of Kenya. And a man who's very, very familiar to athletic fans here in the UK and around the world, of course, still going strong. His first race at the age of 40 for Bernard Lagat, former world 1500 and 5000 metre champion and a regular visitor to these shores. And we also have the man who twice has won the world 1500 metre title, perhaps. For many people, the man who has been the dominant number one 1500 metre runner in the world for the last 6 or 7 years, Asbel Kiprop, who knows this course well. And he couldn't do anything about this man last year, though. Garrett Heath, who won this race rather surprisingly last year, he heads up a strong American contingent here, including Dathan Ritzenheim as well. Watch out for him and one or two other names which I'll mention as we get underway. Shouldn't forget we also have here Japhet Korir of Kenya, the young man who won the world cross-country title last year, going at the shorter distance here of 4 kilometres. Two laps around what has now become a very muddy course. We've had lots of rain, and you've probably been watching the weather forecasts over the last couple of days. Wind, snow. Paula was trying to play the hero role since she was out there earlier on. But lots of people have been taking part in the event. Youngsters, we've had fun runs, all sorts going on here already today. But thankfully now, I think I can say we're having the best of the conditions. The sun has come out and the wind has dropped just a little bit. And now it's really just the mud underfoot for them to contend with. Here's the route. The start, we've just seen them go through, and then they head away from us with the wind down that long back straight. That's probably one of the muddier sections, though, it has to be said. And then they'll turn into the strong wind, cross the road, a little twisty section around St. Margaret's Lock. They don't go up the really big hill though, and then have to negotiate across the brook down to the finish line. Two of those laps and then we'll have our winner. Early stages yet, but Asbel Kiprop forging on at the front, which is good to see. A man who obviously on the track, he doesn't often do this on the track, not sure why he's doing it on the country, but it's good to see him up there. And a very good afternoon. We've already seen Paula, hear from her in a second, but also to Brendan Foster. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you, Steve. And then, as we say, Asbel Kiprop in the dark vest on the outside there, just going past Chris O'Hare, who got a great cheer when he came here. He ran a brilliant race in the European Championships, the Scotsman, was brought up running on the cross-country courses all around this country. He wasn't a great lover of cross-country, but it was where he grew up, and he grew into a great track runner, and hopefully he's got a good future ahead of him. As we were, Dathan Ritzenheim and Bernard Lagat, one of the favourites with all the athletes. Bernard Lagat, second fastest 1500 metre runner in history, Olympic silver medalist back then, and the Olympic gold medalist right now, and at the front alongside Tom Lancashire, last year's winner Garrett Heath, and Chris O'Hare from Scotland and representing Great Britain in the European Championships last year. And the three of them, well, I'm surprised to see Kiprop there, but I'm delighted to see the two British athletes following him.
Well, we've had a little bit of straw put down. You can see the mud is, well, it's all around the course, but there are one or two sections which on downhill can be a little bit treacherous. So they've just moved the ropes inside. You can see they've given them a different line to one or two of the races we've already had, which is good. And Asbel Kiprop taking advantage of the good ground there. And they're well spread out here. He's not hanging around. Lancashire, O'Hare, Garrett Heath, who we're not sure about what sort of shape he's in, though he's had one or two injuries lately, but the others are just starting to catch up now and bunch up behind them, and Kiprop just taking a little look over his shoulder. But this is where they start to turn into the wind. Ewan Thomas is right up there. Zalewski wearing the hat, great steeplechaser, European steeplechaser. So now the field just starting to bunch a little bit, all just settling down. And one or two little slips and slides, we're going to see a little bit more of that. But Paula, you've been out there a little bit. I haven't, Brendan and I have not jogged around the course this time, which is rather unusual, but it is slippy.
It is slippy and wet mud, so very slippery, and there is a camber on quite a lot of the course, which is why I think they've taken that precaution of moving the course in a little bit, just to give the guys a little bit of fresher grass to run on, maybe get a little bit more of a grip. They will be all running in long spikes and they will need them out there today, and I think that's maybe why we saw Tom Lancashire there moving really wide around that straw, so that doesn't get caught and embedded in the spikes, and I mean they've got less grip on it following that.
It's worth mentioning, you've talked about the footwear and the spikes. They're not wearing team colours here. We do have a team competition here in across the junior events, as you heard Jonathan saying at the beginning, the junior events and the senior events, but not this 4K. This doesn't count in the team competition. So it's just the four races, the two junior men, junior women, senior men, senior women, which we'll be seeing shortly. So that's why they're all wearing whatever strip they choose to wear. And this is the bit where they start to cross over and protected from the wind on this section, Brent, which might be a little bit easier for them. Traditionally this was always a tougher part of the course, but they don't go up the big hill now. They go up a little bit and then switch back round.
That's right, but as you look at this field, you see it absolutely loaded. And when you underline Seb Coe's comments, the leader is the two times world 1500 meter champion, Asbel Kiprop, also an Olympic gold medalist from 2008. And Dathan Ritzenheim of the USA attacking Kiprop, but he's just cruising alongside him. Look at this, look at the size of the athlete, look at the style of this athlete, look at his power when he drives. Asbel Kiprop has run this race for the last 3 years. He's been first, second and third, and he looks as though he's come here from Kenya in pretty good shape.
The world cross country champion is about sixth place at the moment behind this group. He's just trying to stay in contact as they start to break away. Longasiwa were in there, a man who track fans, Mo Farah fans will know very well, was the man who for a while looked as though he might pip Mo to the gold medal in London, of course finished with a bronze. He's in the orange vest there. Dathan Ritzenheim has been in great shape coming into this, deciding he wants to very much get involved. But how good is it, as Brendan was saying, to see Tom Lancashire? Tom's had a long journey back to the sort of form which in 2010 saw him run 3:33 for 1500 metres, and it'll be great to see him back. Chris O'Hare had a great year last year. Ross Murray's on the way back. We saw Ross running in a race earlier on today. So for men's 1500 metre running, I think these 4K races are a great test at this time of year, and it's great to see Tom Lancashire doing so well. End of the first lap then. A group of six just pulling away, a bit of a gap there. The World Cross Country Champion trying to stay involved, and then Chris O'Hare just starting to fade back down the field a little bit, but there you can see the names going through.
Yeah, I think standing around at the start, there as these guys were getting ready, it was very cold and very windy, and they were very keen to get moving and to get moving fast in this race, and I think that's why we haven't seen any real tactical bunching here. They're not going to gain a huge amount by trying to sit behind each other, because the wind is so strong and so swirling that it really is just a case of just who's the strongest and who can pick the best line over this ground as well, especially going into some of those ditches and jumps. And you see Dathan Ritzenheim doing a really good job at managing that. And I watched him win in Italy in the Campaccio Cross on Tuesday and looked really good. I think he said he has struggled a little bit to recover from then, but is running strongly out there now, and it's good to see him back.
Maybe a surprise to see his teammate, last year's winner, right up there, Garrett Heath. We'd have been told he'd been struggling with injury problems and maybe wasn't in the sort of shape that saw him win here last year, rather surprisingly. But the fact that he's there with the world cross-country champion, Japhet Kerrer, alongside him. Longasiwa in third place, Ritzenheim on the left as we look at it. Then Asbel Kiprop and those five pulling away from Tom Lancashire.
And Tom Lancashire, Steve, has run an exceptional race there in sixth place, but look at the athletes ahead of him. Oh, fantastic athletes. And as we speak there, Asbel Kiprop, who's had a little bit of a breather there, now goes past Ritzenheim, and the tall figure of the Olympic gold medalist moves into third place. But the race is on between the world cross country champion Korea and last year's winner Garrett Heath from the United States, and Kiprop just taking a bit of closer order. Dathan Ritzenheim running well, but this is a great step forward for Tom Lancashire, who's been missing through injury, has promised a lot. He's obviously a lot stronger than he was in the past, but placing himself right amongst those world-class athletes as Garrett Heath really begins to stretch it now, making a winning run here.
Yeah, I think when he's come here, he's missed a bit of time. He's struggled a bit coming back from injury, but he has those memories of how well he ran here last year to draw on, and I think he knows the course well, and he's judging it well. You can see there, he's just picking the better line through the shorter line and getting onto that better ground, ran that bend there, and now he has made a significant difference just in that short section of the course.
Career having to work really, really hard. The 21-year-old, as I said last year, he took on all comers and will be going to China to defend that title, the World Cross Country Championships, 28th of March, and in Jiyang. I'm not sure what sort of conditions they'll face there. I don't think it'll be as cold as this. But Garrett Heath, he's not bothered at all. Look at how much he's forged. Very strong runner, isn't it? Look at the thighs on Garrett Heath there. He's leaning into the wind now, and he's doing exactly what he wants to, what he needs to do. He knows that there's maybe more pace behind him, but look at that. This isn't about pace. This is pure strength. Even over 4 kilometres, Brent, strength is a big factor. You might look at the distance and think, yeah, the track guys should handle this, but when it's wet, it's muddy, and it's windy, you've got to be strong.
Strength is the factor here, but the power that this man's applying on really difficult underfoot conditions. He seems to revel in England. He won the Great North City Games mile on the quayside last year. He won this race here last year. He's obviously been aiming for this, and when he's looked at the field, he must have been staggered to see the depth of talent in the field. And for him to come here and try and repeat what he did last year was a bit of a tall order. He had been a bit injured. We heard he's been injured, but the gap he's opening up here is astounding. I mean, these are world-class runners. This is the World Cross Country Champion. Just behind him, Dathan Ritzenheim, one of America's top ever distance runners, and just behind him is the world 1500 meter champion in fourth place, but Tom Lancashire is getting amongst them too. So this is a very impressive run by Garrett Heath. Can he keep going? Can he hold on? He'll come under a little bit of pressure, but he looks impressive.
Yeah, he only has a few hundred meters to go now. He'll know that. He's just got to negotiate this stream a couple of times. That's the first time he'll cross it, and he's got one hill, and then he'll turn back. We'll have the chance to work with the wind a little bit in the latter stages, and just needs to be careful underfoot. There's one or two really tricky bits when they cross that brook for the second time. That's the only thing for them to watch out for. Career clearing second. Ritzenheim clearing third, but with a resurgent Tom Lancashire in fourth place, trying to pull away from Asbel Kiprop, and that would be a good performance. Even fourth would be great. If he managed to catch Ritzenheim, that would be an excellent performance from Tom Lancashire. But no doubt about who's going to win this, unless something were to befall him coming down, and it would be a fall. He's strong, as Brent said, a lot of power up that hill, relaxing just through this little section here, but this has been a good run from Heath.
Yeah, you can just see the balance that he has on this course, the way that he's just letting his body almost go down that hill, and totally trusting in his footwear that he's going to have that grip, there's going to be no slipping, and he knows now that he's conquered the most difficult part, and it now is about just getting over this last little ditch and then running into the finish.
He's conquered the most difficult part, but he's conquered in an outstanding field. That little difficult part, he leaned on the barrier there, got over the thing, and now he's stretching away. Impressive, impressive young man.
He could see the finish line. Career just had a little look behind. No danger for him in second place. Across the road for the last time for last year's winner. And now to repeat that in 2014. Said he came here, not sure what sort of shape, how he was going to do. Maybe it was a bit of kidology, because he's been superb this year. Maybe even better than last year. Garrett Heath wins the 4 kilometre challenge. Great performance from him. The American, two in a row. Career, the World Cross Country Champion, in second place. Dathan Ritzenheim makes it. Two Americans in the top three. He takes third, just ahead of world champion Asbel Kiprop in fourth place. And Tom Lancashire holding off challengers from behind to have a very good run in fifth place. First British athlete across the line. Biresh, the world's number one steeplechaser last year, takes six, and then they all start to come in. So he got ahead of Langasiwa. So we'll look at the minor places, but there's your winner, Garrett Heath. I'm not sure whether he was expecting that, but if he wasn't sure about his sort of form, then that will give him an awful lot of confidence as 2015 gets underway. I think I might have said it was still 2014 in that. Hard, isn't it, to remember what year it is when you're as old as me. Anyway, a lot of tired athletes. Chris O'Hare went off hard. Oh, Chris has had one or two little injury problems, but the result is in and confirmed. Garrett Heath wins it for the second year in a row, the World Cross Country Champion, finishing in second place. Japhet Career, Dathan Ritzenheim, strong third from him, Kiprop fourth, Tom Lancashire fifth, and then you can see further down, Chris O'Hare eventually crossing the line in 10th place.